In this video, I'm going to explain to you why stretching is a waste of time. Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. If your goal is to lengthen a specific muscle, you should first ask yourself what your specific goal is. If you are trying to prevent injuries, then you should realize that there is no scientific evidence proving that stretching has a preventative effect. Some people stretch because they think it's important to be flexible. What you should realize, however, is that a short muscle can actually be a functional adaptation and beneficial to you. Imagine soccer players who have to extend their knees quickly when they kick a ball. Short hamstrings will help the knees to slow down the movement, and they thus help to reduce the stress on the passive structures of the knees, like the cruciate ligaments, the knee capsule, and the collateral ligaments. So, trying to lengthen a muscle only makes sense when you have a specific task in mind that will benefit from an elongated muscle. For example, elongated hamstrings might help me to reach the bottom position of a deadlift better with an erect spine. So, do I stretch to get longer hamstrings? Absolutely not. Different studies that we will link in the description down below have shown that stretching does not alter tissue length quickly unless it's done a lot over a really long time, and then the changes in range of motion are rather due to neural effects than due to tissue lengthening. The solution is eccentric strengthening. O'Sullivan et al. In the year 2012 have shown that eccentric training causes sarcomerogenesis, which are added sarcomeres in the muscle because the muscle has to create force in an elongated state. Timmings et al. In 2015 have even shown that this can be achieved with 14 days of just 3 sessions per week. In the case of the hamstrings, there are several exercises. One example that you could do is the Romanian deadlift, next to the Nordic hamstring curl, of course, which severely reduces the number of hamstring injuries and which you can watch by a click in the top right corner. So what you do is that you are only slightly bending your knees during the deadlift, and you are focusing on the eccentric phase by lowering the weight within 3 to 5 seconds. You can pause the weight on the lowest point for about 2 seconds and then move through the concentric phase rather quickly. Okay, we hope you like this video and you give it a thumbs up. Make sure to hit that subscribe button before you leave and check us out on Facebook, Instagram, or become a Patreon. This was Kai for Physiotutors. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.